Me?
The star and the butterfly.
They don't bother anybody. They just go about their business, colorful. Foothills of the Great Smoky Mountains. Shortly after, we moved to a place called Locust Ridge, or as we always like to call it, Over in the Holler. I was the fourth of 12 children, so I pretty much spent my childhood surrounded by people. With that many kinfolk, you're gonna always be fighting for attention. So I was probably louder than I should have been. But then I guess you could say I was just born to be a storyteller. And because so many of my family were musically inclined, I was also determined to tell my stories through song. I started writing songs before I could even write. I started making songs before I even started to school, and my mama used to write them down for me. We were a very poor family, but we were rich in love. Something out of patchwork, she'd try to find scraps that matched as close as possible so that it wouldn't be so obvious that they were scraps. But she knew me and my personality, so she decided to make my coat out of the brightest, most different color she could find. A colorful coat with absolutely no apologies.
Back to the years that grow hard once again.
Learn to believe in yourself. sing hymns at the top of our lungs and pray for a while. Suddenly, it all kind of made sense because amidst all this dirt and dust and decay, God seemed more present than ever. And if he could find me here, he could find me anywhere. And if he believed in someone with such different dreams as me, maybe my hopes of making music and pursuing a greater purpose were not silly childhood ideas, but part of a grander scheme. Mr. Walker had become a multi-millionaire by selling his groceries on radio and TV. And I remember the day that Uncle Bill introduced me. Looked up at him in his star-striped shirt, almost eye level with his belt buckle, which seemed to a poor kid from the hills to be a thing of almost unimaginable richness.
Mr. Walker, I want to work for you.
Well, young lady, you've got a job. A lot of people come to me and say, Mr. Walker, I want a job. But you said I want to work for you. You're hired because you're the first one that ever wanted to work.
And did I ever. This show is broadcast live in the middle of the day from a little auditorium there at radio station WIVK in Knoxville.
You know the boy in pickle way he meets the street. Cause Walker's worst is things can't be big. You got the way of coffee and you want some more.
Do you grocery shopping at a
Cass Walker store?
See you get going.
Do you grocery shopping at a
Cass Walker store?
By the time I was 10 years old, I was on the radio. And I sang on television before my family ever even owned one.
Howdy, neighbors, and thanks for tuning into the program. I need to remind all of you folks about this week's grocery specials. I guarantee these are rock-bottom, cost-cutter prices, and you won't do any better at the big national chain stores. And now, I want to welcome a local gal that's become quite popular on our show. In fact, she's just made her first recording with Gold Band Records. And you wrote this tune, little lady?
I sure did. That is, we, Uncle Bill and I wrote it together.
Well, let's have a listen.
And having never seen a man with such a presence, I didn't know if I'd be able to speak. Well, that didn't last long.
Oh, Mr. Cash, I've just got to sing on the Grand Ole Opry. I've just got to.
You know, I actually think you mean it.
Finally, one Saturday night, Jimmy C. Newman agreed to let me go on in his spot. And when my time came to sing, it just so happened that...
I want you to now. If you'd please make welcome a little girl I met recently. She's from up in East Tennessee, and her daddy's listening to the radio at home. And she's gonna be in a lot of trouble if she doesn't sing tonight. So let's bring her out here, little Miss Dolly Parton!
Well, that girl was me. asking, who's that girl singing harmony? Well, that was just the ammunition we needed to convince Fred Foster that I should be singing some serious country.
Dolly, you recorded a beautiful song recently. Why don't you go ahead and sing, dumb blonde?
Say what?
Well, that came out wrong. Dolly Parton has a new song called Dumb Blonde, and she's gonna sing it for all of you.
Dolly Parton.
than upstairs. It's got two stories. I would say that the real problems that arose between Porter and I were all about dueling dreams. Porter dreamed of me staying with his show forever, and I dreamed of having my own show, my own future. Many people think that the song I Will Always Love You was written about a breakup of two lovers, but in fact, I wrote it about the woman and the special, although painfully heart-wrenching time that we spent together. It was time to move on. They say all good things must come to an end. I say all things must come to new beginnings.
It's been a long, dark night.
Thank you.
My Smoky Mountain DNA are really these kinds of songs. Once I start singing, that music just gets to me. It just hollers at me all the time. Says, you get back in here. This is who you are. This is what you do best.
Just
dumb joke, because I know I'm not dumb. And I know I'm not blonde. The night I graduated from high school, we were all asked to stand up and talk about what we were going to do with the rest of our lives. When it came my time, I stood right up. And I said, well, I'm going to Nashville, and I'm going to be a star. Well, the whole place just laughed out loud, and I was so embarrassed, and I thought, how odd. Why is everybody laughing?
There was a little gal from Tennessee just making her way.
And apparently this little gal had plenty to say.
From her humble beginning, she'd been rise to the top.
With her talent and desire, simply going to star.
She had a look,
a flash.
Or even in the most humble horse-drawn wagon. step away with the dust of that rugged road clinging to our bare feet. Although we seldom realize it at the time, that dust is more precious to us than gold dust. It is the dust of experience, of error, of forgiveness, of risk and reward.
Amen.